I started a playlist, and I'm naming it Hazelnut Lessons. And I want to kind of follow up here since I picked the hazelnuts yesterday. I want to talk a little bit about my planting scheme here. And we'll start right here where I have my, what I'm calling the hazelnut thicket. And I planted the hazelnuts very densely. Of course, when you have seedlings and you plant them, it doesn't feel like it's very dense. Oh, here's one on the ground. Yeah, squirrel clipped it up, but then he didn't grab it. Here's another. He's chewing on. And he left it there. But you can see here's the base of a hazelnut here. Here's another base. I kind of staggered them here. There's another base. Come over here. I've got one over here. Another one here. This one here I dug out. It was smaller, so I dug it out and transplanted it up north. Now I have a bed of ramps in here. Then I have a European that I transplanted in here, and it got girdled by rabbits. So I went ahead and transplanted it over here since it was smaller, and it's in total shade, and it's existing. And then I have one here. So the reason why I think they're too dense now, that's my opinion now, is because they're not growing many branches off to the side. Everything has got to go up, and that's to reach the sunlight. So it's definitely ladders for picking these. But I did notice one positive is I noticed is the squirrels did not take the nuts way at the top yet. Probably because the branches are very whippy. They get up on them, they probably bend over, so there's probably a lot more effort. So I harvested quite a few up on top, even though I had to get on ladders. And since the branches were very flexible, I was able to, even though I was, probably 5 feet below the top branches, I was able to bend them over and harvest the nuts. So I think I'm going to begin to, and my original plan was is I was going to prune every other one at between 8 and 10 years. And then 8 years later, I was going to prune the ones I didn't. So it was going to be on a 8 year cycle, 8 to 10 year cycle. Because I read a study that talked about how the hazelnut trees that are between 5 and 8 years old are the most productive. So if I prune down half of them, but I'll leave the other half grow, so I'll continue to get a crop, then those bushes that I pruned, you know, after 8 years, in 5 years they'll be at their higher performing level. And maybe that's when I'll prune the rest of them, maybe 5 years, maybe eight. We'll see. You know, it's all, what do I feel like doing? What do the circumstances, what are they telling me to do? Look at their more damage. That thicket where the bushes are all growing up, here's one that's more isolated by itself. And you can see there's more branches, more branching going to the side. These are the same lot run of hybrids, these individual ones, as the thicket. And then this is much more bushier. There's a lot more branches coming out, and they're easy just to grab and pull them down and harvest. Oh, see, I missed a couple. Look at that. I'm gonna get them right now. I already picked this bush. See how green those nuts are? Those actually they're husks on the nuts. And sometimes it's hard to tell how many you got on your bush. But these bushes are more productive because there's just a lot more sunlight getting into the lower branches and lower leaves, I think. But I don't know for sure. And I've got some Americans in here that are, they don't grow as tall. And they, man, they're just monster crops of those. I got Americans surrounding the thicket because I wanted the Americans to pollinate the hybrids. The Americans put out a lot more pollen I just swallowed a mosquito. So then we come here to this most productive bush this year. And again, it's by itself. And it has a lot more branching. Let's look at, you see the branches there coming up all through here. Oh, there's some more that I missed. Look at that. The heck. I should break one apart and see what they're like. But and this one's, I don't know if it's getting more sunlight. I don't think it's getting more sunlight because we have this honey locust tree overhead. It's definitely not getting any afternoon sun. And the other part of this is there's a birdhouse here. And I know there's house sparrows nesting in that birdhouse. So is it the birds that are kind of chasing away the squirrels from this spot? Or is it? You see the wooden fence there in the background? That is the preferred route of the squirrels. They run up and down that. So it stands to reason that this is how the squirrels are accessing, and they're harvesting all of the hazelnuts that are next to the fence first. And this bush here, that whole bush, that whole thing is the hazelnut here, that whole thing here. They're not getting to this one because it's not close to the fence. And here we have one that the squirrels were in, but I have this long pulse that I didn't want to just leave it laying on the ground, so I set it up here, and they're running along that fence line and coming down here and hopping in this tree. Oh, there, I missed some more. Wow. I don't take them, the squirrels will. Of course, maybe I want to fatten up the squirrels, right? So I don't know if I would change anything necessarily. I guess I would change something for sure. I've got this Italian bush, this Italian named bush that produces very large nuts right there, and I wanted to put that along the wooden fence because that is a preferred nut tree as the one I want to harvest off of, and the squirrels clean that out in a day. Left me 6 nuts. So I would change that, and I might, what another thing I would do is I would plant the Americans along the fences, along where I think the squirrels are going to access, and put these higher production, larger nut trees in the center where the squirrels would have to either jump from tree to tree or get on the ground. So then a person would have plenty of forward knowledge that the nuts are getting ripe and that the squirrels are harvesting those Americans that are along their pathways, which in that case is the fence. So, you know, if I was gonna change it, I've got my thicket here, and I don't, you know, another part of my experiment was, well, will these ones that are kind of by themselves be pollinated? Well, there's no problem. You know, 12 feet apart maybe at the most in this mixed prototype food forest. Well, maybe 15 feet apart. And whereas the thicket, you know, they're only 4 or 5 feet apart. But these ones that are apart 15 feet, no problem. They all got pollinated. They're all growing nuts. So maybe another experiment is putting them 20 or 25 feet apart in a mixed prototype food forest to find out how that would work. But I've got these Americans around the thicket, and probably what I would do, I would have done different, is I would have just put the Americans along that fence line where, you know, they're running up and down that wooden fence along it. And then they would be eating those Americans, which are a lot smaller nuts, first. And once you see all that signal that they're eating those, now you're going to harvest the big nuts that are away from the fence. That's what I think. So, and being in this prototype food forest with the mixture of different trees in here to besides, and there's no problem with pollination like that, so there's the best tree, and then that one would have rivaled it with the harvest too, but that got harvested by squirrels. So you can see that's about 15 feet away, and then it's about 15 feet to this one, and in between I have pears and cherries, and there's a peach tree, there's a pear tree, you can see the peaches up there, There's a plum tree in there. There's an apple tree in there. Carnelian cherries are in here. There's sour cherries in here. Bush cherries are in here. Nanking cherries are in here. Another apple that's grafted. So in a mixed prototype food forest here, they look good and they play the part. They play a game. They play a team. They play as a team. So I get that all straight. All right. One of the nuts I just harvested. You can see we got solid meat inside there. I harvested most of the nuts yesterday. Trying to know if they would ripen. Well, this time they got that characteristic hazelnut flavor. When I did this a week ago, they were kind of bitter. They're not bitter. That's good. Very juicy. They're gonna be all right. 30 days we're gonna start eating them. We'll see what they taste like.